Boeing will develop the American sixth-generation fighter, now named F-47. The announcement was made personally by U.S. President Donald Trump in the Oval Office, alongside Secretary of Defense Pete Hegseth and Air Force's Chief of Staff General David Allvin. This initiates a new era for the U.S. military. A sixth-generation fighter is expected to include man-unmanned teaming capability with AI-controlled missions, the ability to control a swarm of drones, greater battlefield data fusion, more powerful sensors, greater electrical power generation to equip directed energy weapons, a virtual cockpit helmet-mounted display, allowing the pilot 360-degree vision, etc. General David Allvin, in an apparent dig at China, said, "Despite what our adversaries claim, the F-47 is truly the world's first crewed sixth-generation fighter." In this video, Defense Updates reports on 11 key aspects of the F-47 fighter. The fighter jet has been designated as F-47, F for fighter, and then the number. It's unclear how 47 came about. From F-22 to F-35, and now to F-47, many numbers in between have been skipped. There are speculations that the number has been chosen as Donald Trump is the 47th president of the United States. Trump, however, claimed that the generals chose the number, stating, "It's a beautiful number, F-47. It's something the likes of which nobody has seen before." F-47 is the result of NGAD, Next Generation Air Dominance, fighter program. Last year, the Biden administration's Air Force Secretary, Frank Kendall, ordered a pause on the NGAD program to review if the aircraft was still needed and if any changes were required in light of several rapid advances in aviation and air defense technology, particularly by America's adversaries. In early March, the United States Air Force leadership, speaking at the Air and Space Forces Association's 2025 Warfare Symposium, stated the NGAD program would be continued according to internal study. Kenneth Wilsbach of the Air Combat Command suggested that crewed sixth-generation aircraft will be necessary for the future combat environment, citing increasing risks posed by Chinese sixth-generation aircraft development. Also, the U.S. Air Force's Force Design Director stated that analyses to date show the service will face more operational risk and be less able to achieve assigned objectives without a new crewed sixth-generation combat jet. Air Force Major General Joseph Kunkel discussed this aspect during a talk at the Hudson Institute think tank in Washington, D.C. He is currently the Director of Force Design, Integration, and Wargaming within the Office of the Deputy Chief of Staff for Air Force Futures at the service's top headquarters at the Pentagon. U.S. Air Force wargaming has revealed a need to keep persistent pressure on the enemy in forward areas, and that a force structure centered solely on long-range, standoff capabilities does not win major fights. Before we proceed to next, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Boeing beat out Lockheed Martin. Northrop Grumman had dropped out of the bidding process in July 2023. Viewers may remember that Boeing with its X-32 had lost out to Lockheed Martin's X-35, which ultimately became F-35. Experimental version of a plane in U.S. military has X-tagging. This is a sweet revenge. It is unclear if Lockheed is planning to protest the decision. While we don't know on what criteria Boeing won, one aspect might have influenced the decision. The contract to Boeing keeps all three major aerospace companies floating. Northrop will be working on the B-21 Raider bomber and LGM 35 Sentinel ICBM, Lockheed on F-35 production and F-22 upgrades, and Boeing will concentrate on F-47. The current deal is worth more than $20 billion. U.S. Air Force said in a release that the contract awarded to Boeing funds the engineering and manufacturing development phase, which includes maturing, integrating, and testing all aspects of the NGAD platform. This phase will produce a small number of test aircraft for evaluation. The contract also includes competitively priced options for low-rate initial production. The service added, future basing decisions and additional program elements will be determined in the coming years as the Air Force advances the F-47 toward operational deployment. In response to the announcement, Boeing's stock price closed 7% higher than the previous day's close, and Lockheed Martin's stock price closed 5.7% lower than the previous day's close. This contract is set to rejuvenate Boeing's military aviation sector, particularly its fighter production line in St. Louis, Missouri. In recent years, Boeing has invested billions in new facilities, betting big on NGAD. Steve Parker, interim CEO of Boeing's defense unit, called this buildup the most significant investment in the history of our defense business. This aircraft is not just a concept, it is already a pretty mature platform. President Trump said, "The F-47 will be the most advanced, most capable, most lethal aircraft ever built. An experimental version of the plane has secretly been flying for almost 5 years, and we're confident that it massively overpowers the capabilities of any other nation." Over the last few years, many reports regarding a mysterious aircraft have surfaced online. There is a possibility that some of the sightings are of this aircraft. F-47 will walk in the footsteps of F-22 Raptor, not the F-35. F-22 was designed primarily for air-to-air combat. It is the first operational aircraft to combine supercruise and supermaneuverability. Supercruise is the ability to sustain supersonic flight without having to use highly inefficient afterburners. Raptor incorporates supermaneuverability with many design aspects, including thrust vectoring nozzles that allow the pilot to control the direction of the engine thrust. F-22 can pull off demanding maneuvers like Pugachev's Cobra, and it is an excellent close-range dogfighter. F-35 is more of a multi-role aircraft. It has a low top speed of Mach 1.6 and can't even supercruise. Many experts have called it a bomb truck. Now that there is a clear threat from China, F-47 will be geared towards air superiority. Viewers may note in this context that initially, 750 F-22s were planned, but this was reduced to 195, as there was limited threat perception after the fall of the Soviet Union. Renderings of the F-47 published by the U.S. Air Force concealed many of its features, but the new aircraft is distinctly different from the F-22 and F-35. While the images point to a conventionally stealthy nose and bubble canopy with a chiseled chine and a flattened overall fuselage shape, they also reveal both canards and wings with a distinctive upward angle. Everything suggests a major decrease in RCS or radar cross-section would be achieved. For example, a wing with a very high dihedral and downward swept tips will prevent radar return below. This is similar to Boeing's YF-118G Bird of Prey technology demonstrator that flew clandestinely out of Area 51 in the 1990s. Special emphasis has been given to achieve higher combat availability. General David W. Allvin said the F-47 will be more sustainable, supportable, and have higher availability than our fifth-generation fighters. These likely points to the high maintenance requirement of RAM or radar absorbing material used in F-22 and F-35. F-47, like the sixth generation B-21 Raider, will use a more resilient coating and will have more contiguous stealth surfaces that limit wear and tear. General Allvin claimed the F-47 would also have a significantly longer range than the F-22. The F-22 has a range of more than 1,850 miles, or about 2,780 kilometers, with two external wing fuel tanks. The range enhancement will be largely due to completely new engines, apart from other design improvements. There are two contenders to power the F-47, General Electric's XA-102 and Pratt & Whitney's XA-103. Both feature three-stream adaptive cycle designs for increased fuel efficiency and cooling or additional thrust and performance, depending on the situation. These engines are touted to have 180 to 200 kilonewtons of thrust. For comparison, the Pratt & Whitney F119 PW100 turbofan engine in the F-22 produces 156 kilonewtons. The increased power, apart from providing typical aerodynamic advantages, will also enable the integration of laser weapons that need high power input. NGAD fighter program stipulated the need for the jet to have the ability to control drones known as Collaborative Combat Aircraft, CCA. The CCAs are planned to fill roles like carrying additional missiles, providing extra sensor coverage, or even taking a hit from an enemy in the place of a piloted aircraft. It is reported that the F-47 will be able to fly with 5 CCA drones. This type of configuration will allow the F-47 to go to war with limited weaponry, as the bulk of the weapons will be accommodated by the drones. This virtually eliminates the need to carry weapons externally, which is very detrimental for stealth. President Trump said, "We can't tell you the price because it would give away some of the technology and some of the size of the plane. It's a good size plane." Allvin promised that the F-47 will cost less and be more adaptable to future threats, and we will have more of the F-47s in our inventory. The flyaway cost of the F-22, which covers only the materials required to build a single aircraft and excludes expenses such as research and development, military construction, and other non-recurring engineering costs, was approximately $140 million. When factoring in these additional costs, the total price of an F-22 rises to around $350 million. The per-unit cost of Raptor became high as the numbers were reduced. U.S. Air Force officials have indicated that 220 and 250 NGAD aircraft could be deployed. As per federal law, F-22 can't be exported to any country, even to the closest allies. Actually, the Pentagon has classified many distinctive features, so much so that its pilots are barred from using its full capabilities in international drills, even with close partners. F-35, on the other hand, is being exported to several countries. As of February 2025, 20 countries have purchased or placed confirmed orders. Lockheed Martin has delivered over 1,100 F-35s to customers worldwide, with 110 jets delivered in 2024 alone. On February 13, when Donald Trump met Prime Minister Narendra Modi, he even offered it to India. So the policy for F-22 and F-35 is completely different, and it will be interesting to see what the U.S. decides on F-47.